And I am one of Sylvia Rivera's daughters. Two, I'm speaking loud so people can hear me clearly. Right? And Marshall P. Johnson is my auntie, even though I never got to see him. Right? Basically, Sylvia, Chelsea, and Julia, and Christiana took me into Transy House. There were a bunch of girls that had their own apartment that took girls in to give them a safe place to live. Now, how I'm gonna speak about that behalf, I don't even wanna go there. The point is, they kept a safe haven for girls to live in. After a while, I got tired because nobody wanted to give grants and fundings. Too many girls were sleeping out in the streets homeless, in the parks, in the woods, everywhere in the United States of America. It's time for housing for trans people. It's time for jobs. It's time for job training programs, schools, educations, to educate the parents who throw these kids out in the streets, out of LGBT youth of color, and LGBT youth in general, who are poor minority whites. Also, poor minority whites who are LGBT and people of color, we coexist. Sometimes I wonder when y'all pass these bills on as legislators, elected officials, does it coexist? This is where y'all need to do research. Sometimes I wonder when LGBT or LGB organizations, even though they add the T to it, do y'all really use the grants and fundings for the transgender community? Or is it just for MetroCard and food? What about trans action? What about revolution? Because I'm a revolutionary person. I don't take no shit. I'm like my mother, Sylvia Rivera. I live with mental illnesses. That's not even being treated for transgender people. Because they treat us like we're shit, the psychiatrists, the doctors. They misgender us, all right? And a lot of things are not being done. We also need the pier to be open later on the time where we can have ballroom scene events, where we can be able to have park events for LGBT community. We need to be open late to have a good time with our community. It is not meant for just whites. It is not just meant for LGBT, LGBT whites. LGBT color are welcome on the pier too. Don't throw us out of the village, because if it wasn't for Marshall P. Johnson and Sylvia Rivera, my mother, there will be no gay, lesbian, bisexual, white, transgender rights.
Thank you.
But for white citizens that are of the LGBT community. So I had to speak up for transgender people of color. I also had in here, right, substance abuse programs are discriminating against transgender people. They put us with males, not right. Shelters, we need safe housing shelters for just trans people. We need safe housing for just trans people. We need, because sometimes you can live with women and men and they'll stigmatize you and discriminate against you and terrorize you. Okay. We live as women, as trans women, and trans men live as trans men, and trans boys live as trans boys, and trans girls live as trans girls. And then they came up with all these other names to add to the transgender umbrella. So we need two separate transgender umbrellas.
Thank you.
Because I'm a woman. I had to take hormones prescribed by a doctor. Hello, I have to get it right to your heads. And then the parks, there's no safety, because look at how many girls have been murdered in these parks, have been murdered in New York City and throughout the United States of America. We're tired and we're fired up and we can't take no more. Do something about it as elected officials, as the police department, and as all organizations and agencies and programs. Trans justice, trans power, trans poverty. Respect and unity and unite with us on Trans Day of Action. If you're serious, if you're fake and phony, do not come out to our events.
Good, thank you very much.